the saddest of processions along the mile. The royal family walking in lockstep behind the late Queen's coffin, draped with a royal standard, a wreath of flowers, white roses, white dahlias, a selection of foliage from Balmoral and the gardens at Windsor. The imperial state crown with which Her Late Majesty was crowned in 1953. She would have made this journey in the gold state coach. The final journey now at the end of her long reign.
Thank you.
length of the procession stretches along the Mall in the autumn sunshine. Bill, just to bring you in here for an observation of what we're witnessing.
We're seeing there the King Street Royal Horse Artillery drawing the gun carriage with the coffin, and the procession with various component parts to it, about the lifeguards at the front, and then the band and the foot guards behind that, then the Major General commanding the Household Division and his close staff, followed by the key members of the Royal Household, and then the gun carriage, followed by the bearer party, and flanked by the escort party of the 1st Battalion Grenadier Guards, and the pallbearers, former equerries to the Queen, and the royal family, and then members of the household to the King, and brought up at the rear by the dismounted detachment of the Blues and Royals.
Thank you.
procession moving shortly into horse guards. To their right will be the guards' memorial. Duke of Sussex, centre frame alongside his brother, the Prince of Wales, wearing his RAF number one uniform, garter sash with RAF pilot wings and garter star chest order. Bill, to bring you in here, the scene of trooping the colour, the scene of so many momentous royal.
Yes, and of course, trooping the colour, the Queen's birthday parade, or the Sovereign's birthday parade, in which the Queen took part, you know, before she became the Queen, more times than anybody else has ever done it. So she's very familiar with horse guards. You see the King's, well, the Queen's page there, bottom left of the screen, and the Master of the Horse, bottom right. Earl of Wessex, Peter Phillips, Admiral Sir Tim Lawrence. And behind him, the equerry to the King, Major Johnny Thompson, upgraded now. The Prince of Wales has become the King.
And the King's uniform today, Bill?
He's in the uniform of the Royal Air Force, the Marshal of the Royal Air Force.
We're witnessing two senior members of the royal family now emerging from Buckingham Palace, the Queen Consort, the Princess of Wales. Family members joining the procession, but making their way to the side, to the Palace of Westminster and the Great Westminster Hall, where they will be received before the procession arrives to take their places to view the cortege of the late Queen Elizabeth as it moves into New Palace Yard.
earlier about the poetry or the elegiac nature of such occasions in terms of giving people solace in their grief, but I don't think there's any doubt of the grief on the faces of the royal family. We've heard applause as they've marched. Bill here, passing under a key ceremonial.
Going through Horse Guards Arch, leaving the official palace area. This is where heads of state are greeted, coming to see the sovereign. And as they go through the arch, which is guarded by the Household Cavalry, the King's lifeguard will have turned out and will salute the coffin as it goes out onto Whitehall. As you can see, they've had to adjust and very skillfully negotiate this ancient arch. At the rear of the garrison sergeant major, who's absolutely critical to all of this, Sergeant Major Andrew Stokes, Coast Guard Guards. The royal family. King's Aquarium.
Well, as Bill said, the procession now emerges onto Whitehall, the acknowledged centre of government named after the palace, once Henry VIII's main residence. And of course, soon the Queen's coffin will pass both the cenotaph, the Remembrance Sunday service, something she was loath under any reason at all to miss. And it will then pass Downing Street, home of the 15 prime ministers from Winston Churchill to Liz Truss that she oversaw in her reign, performing her duties as constitutional monarch with a dexterity and subtlety that I think it's fair to say pretty much everyone admired.
Thank you.
Procession there, just passing Downing Street, home of her many prime ministers, and now bearing in on Great Westminster Hall. Of course, the first public figure to lie in state there was William Gladstone, that titan of 19th century politics, but Winston Churchill did too, her very first prime minister, as well as her grandfather, George V, who saw us through the First World War, her father, George VI, who saw us through the Second. A chance for people, as she lies in state there, all around Britain, and indeed from all over the world, to come and queue and pay their own respects. public who've waited many, many hours to see this, seeking to find some way to show their respects in this moment. So it's been something we've seen all along this processional route, just the discreet applause as the Queen's coffin passes.
Bearer party, 6 paces outwards, march. Bearer party, prepare to turn. Prepare to race. Race. Bearer party, inwards. Turn. bearer party. Prepare to turn. Turn. Bearer party. Slow. March